Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel, and I'm bringing back Talk to Me Tuesdays. This week I thought I'd get real personal by answering one of my most asked questions on my vlog channel, Infinity Vlog, and where I vlog my college life and daily adventures and things like that, as well as food videos. But one of my biggest questions that I always get was, why did I transfer from UCSD to UCLA? And if you don't know what I'm talking about the University of California, San Diego to the University of California, Los Angeles. If you watch me for my vlog channel, so just some of my earlier videos on this channel, you'd know that I went to UCSD for my first 2 years and then transferred to UCLA. I never really talked about why, but now that I've graduated, I feel like I really want to give you all my full experience from both schools and just really talk to you about why I personally transferred. Now, I really emphasize on the fact that it's my personal experience. I hope that you all just, you know, take these aspects that I'm bringing that I experienced, and I hope that you kind of take them, but don't take them too personally to yourself, because every single person is different. I know tons of my friends who actually chose UCSD over UCLA, and UCSD is a much better fit for them. For me personally, UCSD just wasn't the right fit for what I was personally looking for, and I'll go ahead and talk about that. I also am going to be uploading at the same time I upload this video, a video about my 4 tips and like tricks and just from my personal experience on transferring from a UC to a UC, so from a University of California to another UC. But yeah, so I'll have that link down below if you want to check that out. And I also have a couple other videos about UCL and UCSD. I'll link those down below as well. But with that, let's just go ahead and get started. So I'm going to talk about the 3 main reasons on why I ended up wanting to transfer out of UCSD. And it was basically just 3 reasons why I didn't think the school was the right fit for me. One is the atmosphere, and UCSD has this reputation of being UC socially dead, and it definitely depends like how you look at it, but yeah, it's not a normal college, normal university, it's broken into 6 colleges, which is kind of funky. All the dorms are spread across campus, while other schools it's all in one centralized location, so you can, you know, like you're more social and you hang out with your friends more. UCSD was really hard because your friends were like really far away. Also, there was no Greek row, so you don't have your own typical frat parties, and you don't even have apartments nearby in general. A lot of the apartments or houses were really far away because the surrounding neighborhood where the school is located is in La Jolla, which is a very wealthy neighborhood, so there's always noise complaint calls if you do throw a party or anything like that. And I wasn't happy just for like that social aspect of like that college experience. But also, I feel like the vibe at UCSD is very, very introverted. And there's nothing wrong with being introverted or just like feeling more introverted. Like, I know I have those days where I need to hibernate and just need to recharge like for myself. And a lot of my friends are, you know, just personally more introverted, and I'm a lot more extroverted. Like, for example, I would literally go into class my first day, and I'd like sit somewhere, and then I'd turn around to someone, you know, next to me or like 2 seats over, and I'd be like, "Hi, my name's Cindy." And literally people, I can count 3 times on the top of my head where this has happened, where people will just ignore me or like they'll look away, or like, yeah, they'll just like pretend they didn't hear anything and just like look down. And I'm just like, well, that sucks. Like, you know, I'm here to make friends, and you know, I'm in college, like classmates, like, so that was really weird for me, and I just didn't feel comfortable. Like, of course I ended up having my huge group of friends that like I love and I visit all the time, and I love them to death, and you all know, like, every single time I visit SD, like, I'm always hanging out with them because they're amazing. I love them. But I think overall as a school, the atmosphere just wasn't right. I felt really just sad, and I just didn't feel very happy, welcome, social. Even like the academic atmosphere, it's very competitive in a negative way. Like, everyone just studies to themselves in the library. Like, no one likes to study, you know, together in groups. Like, it's just, of course I'm saying no one or everyone is like too much, because of course that's not the case, but just a majority of people would be very introverted and would study themselves and be very competitive in a very negative, nasty way. So that is the number one reason why I did not feel very happy there. My second reason for wanting to transfer out of UCSD was, at that time I had a jewelry line called Safade, so I was an entrepreneur, and I really, and also I guess if you count YouTube, that is another part of entrepreneur, I guess, entertainment. And I knew that after I graduated college, I would want to continue being an entrepreneur, be an entrepreneur, better entrepreneur, and I really wanted to join organizations and clubs. What was really discouraging for me though is that UCSD is such a STEM-based school, so science, technology, engineering, and math, that I was denied from clubs and organizations because I was an entrepreneur. I was a non-tech entrepreneur, basically. Like, I was in fashion, aka my jewelry business, and I was doing entertainment, aka YouTube. But I got rejected from clubs that were like, no, sorry, you're not computer science. Sorry, you're not biotech. Sorry, you're not this. Like, I couldn't join entrepreneurship clubs and business clubs to get mentoring connections and friends. And that is so disheartening that such a big university would be so close-minded, especially for a topic like entrepreneurship, when literally any idea can lead to a business. So I thought that was very discouraging for myself personally. I know a couple of my friends who are actually in the UCSD like entrepreneurship clubs, and they love it because they're doing tech stuff, and y'all, since it is so focused, like, they benefit greatly from it. But for someone like me, I just felt very excluded. I know that once I left, UCSD launched a program called The Basement, which I got accepted to, which is cool, but I'm not sure how that program is going or like how it's doing, but hopefully it's doing well, and hopefully they're being more inclusive of all types of entrepreneurs. And the very last thing that made me want to leave UCSD was the location. Yes, the beach is amazing. Yes, it was a 10-15 minute to the beach from my dorm room. And honestly, that was great, especially growing up in Las Vegas in the desert heat. Being able to go to the beach every day was amazing. But to be honest, like, yeah, it does get tiring after a while. You want more. And for someone like me who, again, did grow up in Las Vegas, having everything be 24/7, having, you know, being in a big city with, all, like, events always happening and things always, like, bustling, it was so weird that everything in San Diego closes at, like, 10. It's so hard to, like, get anywhere because everything's so far away because, again, we're in La Jolla. And I just wasn't as happy. Like, the food scene, I was like, it's pretty good, and I'm gonna have some of my favorite places there. My favorite ramen place, favorite burrito place, they're all down there. But overall, I don't know. And for YouTube, I always found myself going to LA. I'd always go up here for Generation Beauty and for IMATS and for VidCon. I'd always be making my way up. Every time I was in LA, I was more excited. There's always more stuff to do. Yeah, there's the beach. Yeah, there was hiking. Yeah, there was all these amazing attractions, like all these fashion places, beauty places. I just relate and connect more with LA, I guess, than San Diego, even though I do like it. It's a great vacation spot, but living there for 2 years was pretty rough for me. Now, I don't want this video to be completely negative, so I'm gonna talk about three things real quickly that I loved about UCSD, and one is the political science department. I'm a poli-sci major, and honestly, wow, the UCSD political science department is remarkable and truly one of a kind. The professors there are amazing, and I miss so many of them because I made so many great connections with those professors. And more importantly, the classes were so incredibly interesting and stimulating. My favorite poli class of all time was at UCSD, and it was this class called How to Win or Lose an Election, and it was taught by Professor Fletcher, who was actually a California state senator, and he ran for mayor. So he won and lost elections. So it was so cool to learn from him, someone who was actually, you know, out there in the field doing what many of us wanted to do, and that was run for public office. Second thing is, holy schmoly, student government there is intense, and in the best way possible. Everyone is so close-knit and encouraging and passionate and empowering, courageous, and truly puts their time or commits their time to making a difference for the students of UCSD. I was part of student government both years, and wow, I loved it. It was truly one of the highlights of my experience there at UCSD. So if you want to get involved and you love student government, UCSD has amazing student government programs. There's like many of them. And the last thing is, of course, my friends. Like, I've met so many incredible people there at UCSD. So even though I wasn't happy with the university itself, the friendships I made along the way are gonna last me a lifetime, and I'm so grateful for that. So, yay, UCSD! So if you watch my old vlogs, you would know that I applied to multiple different schools, and I ended up choosing to go to UCLA to transfer into UCLA, and it was really a great, great, great experience for me. I've met so many incredible people here. Just like at UCSD, like my boyfriend, like Kelvin, like some of my best friends, like Emily and JR and Jake and Rachel, just like so many incredible people here that, you know, I'm so grateful for. Now, I'm going to give you some pros of UCLA from my experiences in the last 2 years. The next thing is, wow, everyone here is so incredibly passionate, and the school is very competitive. So let me back it up. First, passionate. Wow, everyone here is incredibly smart, just like at UCSD, but everyone here, I feel like, is passionate. I think that's so different, is that everyone here is doing something other than academics and doing it to a whole nother level, which is great. Like, I know so many friends who are incredible athletes, who are amazing researchers, or who participate in, like, volunteer programs, and just everyone is doing something so much more than just academics, and I think that's amazing. And the second part of that is it's competitive, and in the best way possible. Like I said, I felt at UCSD it was a very negative competition, as in everyone would, you know, want to push each other down, would study to themselves, like, I'm doing my thing. But here it's so competitive in a way that inspires you. Everyone's willing to help each other, everyone's willing to study in groups and just really push each other in the most positive of way. I would like to say I'm a good public speaker, and I took a public speech class here at UCLA, and I was like, I'm gonna kill it, it's gonna be easy. Walk in, everyone is a great public speaker. I'm like, okay, well, I gotta step up my game. And the thing is, everyone else is so encouraging, like, everyone was giving great constructive criticism and feedback, and, like, just so positive, and I don't know, that's such a great feeling to know that you're pushing yourself and you're pushing others in the most positive of way. Alright, the next thing is, of course, the social scene here is killer! Like, come on, you have frat row, you have sorority row, you have so many social clubs, you have so many social orgs, and just so many different groups. Like, even if you're not a social org, like, dance teams will have, like, parties, and we'll do retreats, and we'll do camping trips. Like, there's just so much going on all the time. There's always something new going on campus, and it's great. Like, even just concerts, there's dance, like, dance nights, like, salsa nights. Like, on campus, there's just so many things happening, and that's so fun. Like, I joined a sorority when I was here, and I just had a blast. And yeah, come on, you get that college, you're in college, like, you gotta have that true college, like, party experience as well. That's part of it. Work hard, play hard. And then fourth is food. UCLA has some of the best food in the nation. We're literally, like, critically acclaimed and ranked so good. You know, if you watch my vlogs, food is bomb. And as a foodie, that makes me so happy. And the very last thing is location. I feel like I've just been able to grow and explore all of this wonderful, not just city, but county. There's so many different food places, so many different things to do, landmarks, and I've just made a lot of memories here, YouTube-wise as well, going to a lot of YouTube events and meeting a lot of infinities, so yeah. And to keep things fair, I'm gonna go ahead and name three cons that I feel I've experienced here at UCLA. First thing is, holy crap, living in LA is expensive. As good as it is and as fun as it is, LA is expensive. Housing here is it almost double? Depending on the situation, whether you get a single or not double, if you live on campus or not, it can be almost double of what UCSD in regards to housing, which is very expensive just because LA is more expensive. And I mean, that's what you get for living in a great city that's so densely populated and filled with opportunities. But yeah, it is really expensive, and I know that's a really big factor when choosing a college is expenses. The second thing is, honestly, UCLA is just so much harder academically. It's so much more rigorous, and that might come from the competition, or it might just come from, like, the quote-unquote more prestige or, like, higher ranking, but it's harder. Like, I've definitely found myself struggling a lot more here than I did at UCSD with classes, so you definitely gotta put in the work. Yeah. And lastly, I would go ahead and say that the poli sci department at UCLA is good, but it's not great. It's not as good as UCSD's poli sci department. The classes are very average. Not average, but, like, they're, like, typical classes you would think of for poli sci, like the study of, you know, war. I don't know. I just felt like I had a much better experience at the UCSD poli sci department just because the classes were more interesting and the professors were a lot more engaging here. Professors are scary and, like I said, rigorous AF. But okay, so this video is already long enough, and I wanted to keep my videos a lot shorter, but I feel like this is something I really had to fully explain. I couldn't just throw things out there. I really wanted to try to explain them to the best of my abilities. And again, I really hope that you all take this as my personal experience. I get asked about this all the time, so here I am answering it, but I don't want this to dictate your experience. Remember, your experience is uniquely your own, so make your college experience great. You are the one that's in control of that, and you have all the power to make it amazing. But alright, if you want to check out the second part of this video where I give 4 tips on transferring from UC to UC, definitely check it out. I have it linked down below and at the end. And thank you all so much for watching, and I will talk to you all in a future video. Bye! Mwah.